So today we're off to Durham and we're going to have a good look around the town and go to Durham Cathedral.
Decisions.
We're parked in the park and ride, which for our American friends, you will never have heard of a park and ride. Our roads are so small and car parks can be quite tiny as well. So we have things called park and rides, which is where you can park your car and go in at a very small charge on the bus. And it's quite a nice way to do it actually, because the service is very quick. And if I flip you round, you'll see the bus is just pulling up.
£4 to park and ride the bus.
Thank you.
Mama told me he was going to war, he was leaving. Leaving.
We're using GPS to know when to get off the bus.
I've got to leave for Durham town.
This is Durham's indoor market.
Shoelaces, yeah. I want some good ones though.
When I was a boy, I spent my time sitting on the banks of the river tide, watching all the ships going down the line of name.
Along here, we should find Durham Castle and the Cathedral.
I've gotta leave old Durham town.
So on the hill there is Durham Castle, but that now forms part of Durham University.
And that leaving's gonna get me down.
I'll give you a leaflet, and I'll just let you know what's going on today. So, you've come through our Galilee Chapel, and you're just here now at the visitor desk. There is a restaurant and a shop which you can access through the medieval cloister.
The author Bill Bryson lavishes praise on Durham Cathedral, not just because of its beauty, but the unpretentious way it is run. He concludes, without hesitation, that Durham has the best cathedral on earth. After his death, St. Cuthbert became one of the most important medieval saints of Northern England. He was a monk, bishop, and hermit associated with the monasteries of Melrose and Lindisfarne. Construction of the cathedral as we know it today was started in 1093 by Bishop William of St. Calais. The cathedral is set upon a rocky outcrop, with the medieval city of Durham below. In 1650, Oliver Cromwell used the cathedral to imprison 3,000 Scots prisoners from the Battle of Dunbar. We checked out the bridges and then we decided we needed some lunch. We found a little cafe on the banks of the River Weir.
I've got to leave old Durham.
See, I've got falafel, flatbread with chili jam. Salad and taco chips and tzatziki.
A bacon stack of pancakes. with maple syrup, and there is nowhere near enough maple syrup there.
1944. I remember Daddy walking out the door. Mama told me he was going to war. He was leaving. I've gotta leave old Durham town.
This was our first trip to Durham, and we were quite surprised how small the city is.
So that's Park and Ride.
One car.
Sitting on the banks of the River Tyne, watching all the ships going down the line.